The path to the lighthouse was narrow and treacherous, with jagged rocks protruding from its surface like gnarled fingers. Rhys and Clay slowly made their way upward, slipping more than once on the slick stones. The cliffs towered above them, seagulls swooping down from the heights to skim along the waters below. As they climbed higher, the sound of waves crashing against rocks grew fainter, replaced by the whistling of the wind as it cut itself across sharp edges of stone. The lighthouse appeared, its white stone walls looking like bone against the dirty gray sky. The door was open, the entrance hung with yellow caution tape. As Rhys and Clay approached, a police officer ducked beneath the tape and approached them. He was a bulldog of a man, shaved head, hanging jowls, and a pugnacious look that suggested he was not a man to cross lightly.
"You must be the two I was told to expect," he said,
stopping in front of them with his hands on his hips. "Officer Link," Rhys said, putting out her hand. The officer shook it.
"Frank Butters,"
he said, his expression not changing. He shook Clay's hand next, and then he jabbed a thumb over his shoulder at the lighthouse.
"Couple of kids went out in a storm last night," he said. "Thought they'd have a romantic evening on the water, enjoy the sunset and all that."
He grunted.
"And they came up here?"
Rhys asked, putting the pieces together. Butters nodded.
"Same path you two came up. Lighthouse was unlocked, so they went inside. Started getting a little frisky. You know how it is at that age. And..."
"Hold up," Rhys said, feeling as if she'd missed something. "How old are these two?" Butters sighed as if exasperated at having to pause his story.
"Early 20s, late teens. Hell if I know. Either way, they looked like they had an idea of turning this place into their little love shack. That was the guy's idea, anyhow. But instead, just when things are starting to get steamy..."
"They come across a body," Clay finished. Butters snorted.
"Yeah, that's about the long and short of it. Body was carted off earlier this morning for an autopsy."
"Did you get a look at the victim?" Rhys asked. Butters shook his head.
"Heard it was a man. Not sure the cause of death. Could have been an accident, for all I know."
Rhys nodded, though inwardly she doubted this was just an accident. She was pretty sure Chief Moore wouldn't have put her and Clay on the case if he didn't have good reason to suspect foul play.